Hi, everybody. My name is Hester Abba, and I wanted to start off by pointing out that I'm from the UK. I'm naturally quite reserved, shy. This is definitely not my natural place to be, standing up in front of people, so I'm terrified right now. And that icebreaker exercise with the cards, I pretty much wanted to die. So this will set the scene, hopefully. The other thing that I am, unlike Steph, is I'm a crazy overthinker. So I'm really worried right now that you won't like me, that I am not going to be funny enough, that everyone is looking at me. And I basically, whenever I have an issue with somebody, then I would, again, rather die than bring it up. So I will smile my way through any situation. Pretty much even if you're kicking me or punching me, then I'll be nodding and saying, this is perfectly fine. And so I'm just going to tell you a little bit about my kind of startup journey, as we're calling it tonight. So this cringeworthy slide is my Sassy Media Group history in a nutshell. So this was basically we started Sassy Media Group in 2010 in Hong Kong, where I used to live. I started it with my two best friends at the time. I had recently been made redundant from my job at a design agency after the financial crisis. And we started this business where we basically got it to be fun to organize events for women. And our first Sassy Hour, as we called it, had 7 people show up. And weirdly, our second one, we had 40 people. And then the third one, we had 100 people, and we kind of realized that we were onto something. Started a website, started developing content. We were kind of a little bit pre the whole like blogger thing. So people didn't really know what to do with us at the time. But we organized some large scale events in Hong Kong. And this is my best friend here in the red dress, and my other best friend, the blonde, in the gold dress. And starting businesses with your friends is, it seems like a good idea at the time. So basically, I've gone from being a co-founder of Sassy Media Group to a founder, no co, in my life at the moment. We basically found that just because you like to go out for a drink together and you have really fun ideas and get excited about them doesn't mean that you have the same work ethic, values necessarily when it comes to work. So we pretty quickly discovered that it was not necessarily a great fit. But because we were all so nice, we just kind of bottled it up inside and smiled through everything until we basically almost came to blows. And then we were luckily kind of saved by the bell because one of our co-founders relocated to the US. And so we went from 3, which is a super difficult number. If anyone who has kids who play together or do playdates will know, 3 doesn't work as a number. In my experience, like, there's always someone who's left out. There's always someone who feels hard done by. And so as soon as there were just 2 of us, it kind of started to work a lot better. And so the business started to go quite well, but we were still struggling with the problem that people just didn't take us seriously at all. And I think that this goes back to something that Elijah was saying, maybe about like slight sexism in kind of a tech or media sphere. What we were doing kind of fell into tech weirdly, but no one wanted to treat us like it was tech because it was media, but digital media. So we walked into a lot of meetings where people thought that we were there to work for free as a favor to them. So can you organize an event for 500 people, please? And we'll give you like a couple of drinks on the night. So we had to develop a thick skin quite quickly. We got given a lot of advice by people who thought that they knew what we should do, and we kind of just had to toughen up pretty quickly. And so then we made our next fuck up, which was we hired one of our best friends to be the editor of our site because she was a super great writer and we thought it would be good, and it wasn't. Basically, my new maxim is like, never hire someone you can't fire. So you have to, if you can't give feedback to somebody, then it's going to be awful. And because, again, we were all so fucking nice, we just waited until it was a disaster, imploded, lost the friendship, and it's still something which today, like, is awkward at social events. And then, just as business was going super well, we started really gaining some great numbers in terms of our email database, our web traffic, we started making money. We made a really dumb deal. We merged with another company, which was actually smaller than us. But we, you know, they said it would be good if we would split the company equally. They said that we should sign the shareholders agreement, and we shouldn't get a lawyer involved, you know, because they had their lawyer check it and it was fine. So we said, that sounds great, yeah. And it turned out that it fucked us for years. We signed a super minority friendly shareholders agreement, and my business partner and I were actually, we had the largest shares out of everybody. We ended up though needing unanimous approval for pretty much everything, including paying ourselves. So we had to work for 2 years pretty much for nothing. So that was really great. And after all this, so Sassy Media Group is still going. And in Singapore, we have a site called Sassy Mama Singapore, which if you're a parent, you might be familiar with. So it still does very well, but we're still confounded by the terms of this JP agreement. And so I decided that I really just wanted to be, like an incubant said, just alone with a laptop in a room. So I decided to start a design agency. And I unfortunately, I forgot that you still have clients. And so that hasn't really worked in terms of being alone. And I really miss actually the kind of social relationship of being with another co-founder, and having somebody to ask questions to or someone to complain to, because you can't really complain to employees in quite the same way as you can to someone who knows exactly what it's like to be going through the same thing. So I guess if I was going to give a cheesy sum up, it would be that if I was ever going to do this again and start a third business, and be a complete glutton for punishment, I would really want to have someone kind of by my side as a trusted advisor and sounding board, because I think that doing it by yourself is super tough. And to anyone who's done like what I would call like a real startup by themselves, which is some kind of, which I always think of as, I guess, something self-deprecating, and but like a real startup where you have investors and you know, super lots of pressure, I really don't know how people do that on their own. And I think that the best kind of co-founder that you can find is someone you can actually have a real honest fight with. And then know that you're not going to like lose the friendship at the end of the day.